been holding on to this idea for a long time. It's nothing super special, but I haven't done it before. I was pretty much just waiting for the new expansion to come out, and it has. It's changed a lot of things. Basically, we're just doing regular Hoi 4 until there's only one left. And obviously, there's going to be certain countries that have a lot better chances of winning than others, but I guess we'll see. I mean, you never know, because this game's going to play out for a really long time. We're definitely going to get all the way till probably the 1950s, and I don't even know if everyone is going to be eliminated, but pretty much everyone. There pretty much is going to be one left. The way I'm going to do this is when there's only one, either the Allies, the Axis, or the Comintern that dominates everyone, that's when I'm going to break that faction up, and then the chaos will continue. Like I said, this is with the brand new expansion, so we're going to see a lot of different things, one of them being like a major, like super crazy civil war in Spain. I think it's going to be more than just one or two sides, and that might even happen in other places, depending on, I don't know, what type of areas they choose to go down. We even got some new sexy people. I am so glad the strongest country in the game is finally being properly represented. And you know what? This guy's definitely gonna win. Pretty obvious. I think actually we're gonna see a lot of new faces here, depending on, like, what ideology, you know, who chooses what type of ideology. There's probably some weird stuff in there. Unfortunately, Italy is not gonna be the first people to go, although they were close. I don't know. Ethiopia's gonna be the first place to go. Italy might have a chance of winning. You never know. Oh, I doubt it though. I think at the very least you got to be like a great power, one of the like seven major powers. I don't even know. Maybe just top six. There it is. They took one state. I guess they're technically the first ones on the board. So for now, I'm gonna leave these puppets alone. But eventually, I'm gonna have everyone annex their puppets because we can't have puppets and there be only one left. That's not gonna work. And the chaos has already begun. Not only do we have nationalist Spain and regular Spain, but also Aragon. Right, Aragon. I never thought we'd see them in this game. And we already have communist Portugal, and again a new face, maybe not quite as sexy as Tanatuva, but yeah, I mean, it's a nice stash, and he's gonna support, I'm assuming, the communists in Spain too. It's a miracle Francisco Franco isn't here yet, and that probably makes me happier than anyone else can be. This guy is still in power, he's trying to fight for his life, and then we got like a bunch of people, anarchists in Aragon. Dang, it's getting even wilder. Okay, we got even more people. We got like a Spanish dictionary, Spanish direct dictionary. That's fine. Portugal is also trying to take back from commie Portugal, I guess. Oh, I like that they got this little piece in North Africa. And regular Spain and communist Spain are actually working together in this scenario. Not exactly together, but they're fighting the same enemies, so they're kind of in an alliance. Not officially, though. Not officially. Another internal conflict, this time in Mexico. We've seen these ones before. I wonder if it's going to deteriorate as bad as Iberia. Aragon has taken 10 states away from the Spanish directory. That still sounds so weird, but I guess that's the thing. So they were fascist. They ain't fascist no more because they dead. And things aren't going to get too crazy in Mexico, at least. I think regular Mexico should be able to beat this Mexico. And it's just all hit the fan at the same time. So the official start to World War II is probably going to happen pretty soon because, yeah, this is like a good sign. China's another one that I didn't even think about. China could totally win this. If they, like, unite enough of their warlords, yeah, especially because the Soviet Union will definitely be dealing with Germany. And Mosley has taken over in the UK. So that means we're going to have a fascist Great Britain. And also that means all their puppets, I think, will get to, I think they're going to leave, right? So far, everything looks mostly normal. Obviously, Japan formed their own faction, Co-Prosperity Sphere, and Portugal joined the Comintern. So that's a little different. Now, the UK is not going to join the Axis, I don't think, especially because I think I don't even know if I can say his name. Skinny Mustache, probably gonna go after Czechoslovakia soon. Well, there you go. India is now free, and Japan hasn't made much progress against China. Not yet, at least, but it looks like they're starting to. Oh, wow, and the European theater has started. And, of course, it's looking like this for Germany. Well, Germany's not gonna win. The craziest thing, though, is that Poland joined their side? How did that happen? I didn't think that was even a possibility. That's just regular Poland, too. What? I'm really confused about that. Well, unfortunately, Poland's still not gonna make it out of this. They also do have a homie in Northern Iberia, but that's not really gonna help much. So, pretty much, it's safe to say we're gonna be with the Allies and the Soviets, the Comintern, soon. I don't think the British Empire, yeah, the British Empire is definitely not going to save Germany. Maybe if they left the Allies, but then they're the leader of that faction. I don't think that can happen. Okay, that's definitely a problem. Just notice the UK is at war with Portugal, and I'm assuming that means the Soviets will probably join it. We already have like a three-way war. At least we're about to. So Spain joined the Comintern, and that means all of Iberia will be, I guess, on the communist team. That's gonna make things wild. And if that wasn't enough, Italy is now on the Allies, and they haven't changed at all. That is Benito Mussolini that is attacking Germany. I mean, maybe it's gonna work. He does like to change sides. Oh yeah, Portugal's gonna lose all their colonies in Africa because they're going after the UK. Not a good idea. Dang, Britain lost all their puppets, didn't they? Except for Malaya. but literally every single other person else, they gone. Well, I guess the big question is, who's gonna take all this? I think the Soviets will probably take Poland, but will Italy or France take the remaining part? This is actually gonna make things really easy to break the faction up, because this faction already has like a weird combination of people. And is the US not gonna do anything? I know they have like an option to support the Axis, but I don't know if they're gonna do that here. The British now going after Ireland, probably not a good idea, guys, but okay. Germany after the Dutch, Germany after Belgium and Luxembourg, probably. Let's see what side they join. And not really much progress has been made on the East Coast. Surprised about that, because sometimes Japan like easily rolls in here, especially because this China's not even that strong. They don't have any like backup help. And now Pakistan has broke away from India, and they're dealing with their own like internal thing. Also, like something's going on with Malaya, Siam and Malaya, that's happening. Wait, why is France and Siam into it too? I'm confused. Argentina has just taken out Uruguay, and that's it. Venezuela joined, I think, Germany's faction. Okay, well, I guess that's gonna help. Thanks for that, guys. What is happening with that? Anything super different? No, nothing too crazy. Oh, Peru joined the Allies, by the way, and that's kind of it. Oh, and Ireland has joined the Comintern, which they took back Northern Ireland, because I'm assuming the British are probably, they got their hands full. Germany's about to fall soon. Some more stuff, this time in Central America, because why not? We gotta eliminate every single country, so you know what? Thank you, Mexico. And Spain has taken back control. They're just like regular, normal Spain. Although they're still on the Comintern side though, I think. Qingshan has broken away from Japan, and that was a terrible idea. Why did you do that? You should not have done that. Japan is also, I guess, still struggling. And they're at, oh, they're going after France and the, maybe that's why they're having so much trouble right now. They're distracted. So that's starting to happen. Good to see some action in this location. Oh, and the British coming in to clap them cheeks. Portugal is not gonna make it through this. And I think Spain probably is gonna have some struggles here. Oh, Germany's almost dead. India is surprisingly losing to Pakistan. And I don't know why that is. Qingchina ain't gonna make it. And Japan is, they can't even invade China. Again, the Allies are causing issues. Argentina and Brazil. Thank you. I didn't know if anything was going to happen in South America, but all right, I'm happy now. Oh, wow. Just realized that all of Benelux, I think except Luxembourg, joined the Comintern. Also, Czechoslovakia joined the Comintern. Ireland's probably going to get taken out too. Dang it, Ireland. I really thought they were going to win. Pakistan is in the Ecuadorian Union, as they should be. Oh, yeah, and that means that the Dutch Indonesian area, they're also part of this. Okay, so there's just a big old peace deal for the Axis, and France got a majority of it. France is Venezuela. And this part of China, for some reason, I don't know how they got that. And then they have a lot of Central Europe, so now it's time to take on the Soviets. North America has formed the American Union with Mexico, and that means that there's probably not gonna be anything happening in Europe anytime soon. Maybe, no, I don't think so. Cause also Japan probably ain't gonna make it either. That's really massive though, that France took a lot of the territory, especially cause they can get all of Spain too. And from there, I mean, they are still connected to this Soviet land. Maybe they'll be able to just take all of Russia. Oh, that explains a lot. They also puppeted things and I had to annex that for them cause we can't have any puppets. Maybe that's why they're being so aggressive. Well, Brazil now looks like they're the immediate favorite to take out South America, the rest of South America, unless France, well, France now got two places here. They could actually do well. A whole lot of naval invasions coming out of the Allies too. Maybe that's a good sign. I mean, it's not like that's gonna help much against this giant monster. Thing is, Stalin is dealing with a two-front war, and that is the thing that we were talking about. Japan isn't, they're not down yet. Look, they got all this stuff because France lost that immediately. I don't know how they're gonna keep that. Yugoslavia took out Greece. I don't know if this is like a final peace deal. I don't think it is, but they're not a part of any team. It looks like, at least. And then we got Turkey versus Bulgaria. Sorry, Bulgaria. I don't think this is gonna go well for you. It's getting a little scary for the Allies. Spain is really pushing in hard, but luckily the British have a little invasion in Galicia, so I guess, oh man, that's an organized invasion, definitely. Great job, guys, keep it up. Oh, India has won in Pakistan, surprisingly. Also, Iran is making a little bit of progress here too. So this is the new world order, I guess. I don't even know if that phrase works in this scenario. I've just always wanted to say it. So France took everything. I think France has gotta be the immediate front runner. Although the British have all of Iberia, not sure if that really matters. Oh, and all of Greece. Italy took like half of Germany, and that is still Benito Mussolini in power, so good job, bald man. I'm assuming next the Allies are all gonna go after Japan, and yeah, they are all a part of the Allies for now, and I'm gonna keep it like that again until they've gotta be like the only dominant faction left. I don't even know how they're able to keep this. I get it because, you know, Italy is fascist and so is the British, but the French are communists, so I don't know. I thought they would leave by now. Actually, they might once they take out Japan. They've got to take out Japan first. That's not going to be easy, but it won't be too difficult either. And now the Arabian Peninsula? They also took out Oman? Okay, I'm really liking this. It's forming. Yes, Bulgaria did get taken out, by the way, and Romania is... Well, Romania's looking okay. They were looking okay. Yugoslavia? No, I guess they didn't get to keep Greece. Like the random, just perfect Belgium borders that... Oh, Belgium and Luxembourg borders that the British have. And speaking of random, we have Belarus. Just... here, and they don't even look like themselves. They just like a disgusting blob. They do touch tips with Lithuania though, so maybe they could, you know, expand it to the Baltic states, maybe? That is, of course, if Scandinavia doesn't do anything. I'm surprised Scandinavia's just been chilling here the whole time. That's a huge French commute, man. I hope the French don't take all of China. That'd be a very bad sign. Now, there are also invading Japan. Is that them? Oh, no, that is the American Union and the US. They are the ones invading Japan as they like to, well, no, they don't like to do. That doesn't work. They like to do other things though. We're not going to talk about that. The French Commune now have all of Indonesia because, well, they might have had it before, but now they for sure have it. And so far, again, still everyone's chill in Europe, except for this area. I don't know what that is. Greater East. Okay, who is that that's invading? Oh, that's a fascist France that broke out. Fascist France broke out of a communist France. Well, that's unfortunate because, man, you guys don't even have a chance. Anyways, like I was saying, the Allies are still super dominant right now. I don't know what's going on. Oh, okay, South Africa is Asian now. And the U.S. did take all of Japan. So they've got two little areas in the Pacific. Not that that is really going to matter against all this. North America's looking really weak right now. Maybe if you get Canada on your side, but Canada doesn't want to get involved. Canada does win all their conflicts, though, if we're going to take, like, real history. So if they do get involved, y'all are good. And here we go. It is our already begun, so let's see exactly what happens here. The Allies have like little jumping off points from Peru and Venezuela, French Venezuela. This conflict actually started up because of the Dominican Republic and Haiti. I was wondering when that was gonna play out because we need this island to unify. But yeah, that's gonna cause like the greatest, like this is pretty much WW3. Is it WW3 or is this like 4 now? All the while, quietly, we've got a country here just eating up places. Maybe they can win. If they take out Turkey, they can still go, they have to go after Turkey because you can't go after anyone else. You don't want to at least. Wow. And unsurprisingly, this is immediately not going very well. The U.S. was not prepared for this at all. So the British are invading from like New England and Florida. Italy even got some stuff too. Also, Asian South Africa has been taken out. So that's very depressing. Something's going on in Australia. We've got like fascist imperialists rising up out of Australia. And I don't know if they were on the U.S. I think regular Australia was on the U.S.'s side and they're not going to make it. Oh yeah, that's actually really bad. So the Allies just have everyone's like, it's just all the Eastern Hemisphere versus just not even all of North America. And we already know, like, that's not enough. Even if you had all of this, it's still not enough. Oh, I just saw this. Paris Accords. Paris has now finally broken away from the Allies. France is gonna do their own thing. So UK has Italy's help, though. Hey, Italy, that's always a great partner, right? I wonder if they will go after each other in the middle of the invasion of the US, because that would obviously be very bad, but I don't know. Well, we have our winner, and the British have taken everything, which they desperately needed. Nothing's happened too much in South America. I'm guessing we know what the next thing's gonna play out. What is Qing China doing? Oh, Qing China's a part of the Allies, so all of these things are gonna add up. Oh, and they took all of Japan too. So they have Qing China a lot. They pretty much took everything away from America. They also have Italy. The UK might be able to face France, even though France has all of this. They have India too. I guess they got a puppet. They got something. Like, I don't know how that happens. Plus all of China. I don't even know if this is gonna be enough. Like, look at all this stuff. France is too strong. And then Brazil is kind of the wild card. Brazil could join either side because I think they're not aligned, so it just depends on who attacks them or not. Oh, Lithuania took out Belarus. I thought the other way was gonna happen, but I guess not. Maybe that their navy helped. They must have had a navy that helped, right? I'm just kidding. Romania is also going after Yugoslavia. Is anyone else helping? Is Italy? Oh, Italy's attacking too. Oh, man. And Turkey? I think Turkey's... Oh, that's not even fair, guys. Of course, Yugoslavia, once again, has just been split apart. And here it is. This is it. Britain versus France for all the marbles. Problem is, the British have a lot of homies. They got Italy. They got Qing China. They got Turkey. Wait, no, Turkey's not there. They got... they have Iran? When did Turkey get taken out? Also, the problem is, France, like the core of France, is completely surrounded, like, already. I know that you have, like, all this power over here, but if you lose your capital, that's kind of an issue. Wow, I didn't even realize that we have imperialist Canada. Oh, it's been a long time, creepy-ass Walt Disney. I've missed your face so much. Oh, well, the French at least have Romania on their side, but Italy is going to take them out, I think. I mean, Romania is kind of surrounded. Surprisingly, I think the Italians are going to be a pretty nice little friend here. Also, what's going on with this China down this way? I don't know what this China is doing. China is on France's side, kind of, even though France doesn't even like them. It looks like the French just weren't strong enough. I bet you they would have been if they had more time to develop some of this new land, but they had too many different enemies from all different sides. Also, they needed Brazil's help, but Brazil decided to stay out this whole thing. They did not want to get involved. How terrifying would that be if Italy got all of Russia now? Maybe they could win. Are they going to pull like the ultimate twist in history, the ultimate comeback? It would be the Italians. I've shit on them so much. Oh no, they didn't get all of Russia. Here's the peace deal. They got a lot of Europe though. They do look good. At least Benito kind of is doing their Roman Empire thing now, officially. They need Iberia, but this is good enough. Actually, they need all of this too, but this is really close for the AI, honestly. I think Bald Man did good this time, at least. Wait, okay, just wanted to make sure Bald Man was still in power. Yep, he's still looking good, and they haven't changed at all. They made it to, like, the final two. They just have to beat the British, which, unfortunately, I don't think that's gonna happen. Obviously, they are no longer on the same team. There's the European group and whatever Italy forms. Brazil could help, but I don't know. Oh, there's this yellow allies. Oh, yep, they're coming in hot. Fascist Britain is coming in strong. This is not gonna be enough. Oh, Qing China probably is helping out a bit. Not a whole lot, but it's, you know, a little bit. Surprisingly, the Italians didn't lose the African front, so at least that's something. That's kind of a pat on the back. I don't think Italy, we could say Italy got second place, right? Brazil does look good. They took out Peru and Bolivia, and they're almost in control of all of South America. The British have annexed Canada, so there's just them in North America for the most part. I mean, I guess this is going on, but luckily a lot of these smaller countries have already been taken out. That's been like a huge help. And here's our winners with pretty much just one left. There's actually a couple stragglers that obviously they mean to take out, but it doesn't really matter. The fascists have won, and I didn't think it was gonna play out like that. I was actually really worried that it was gonna be a democratic nation. I think I would have probably just forced them to annex countries that turned other countries democratic. So Denmark survived. It's actually kind of funny to see the countries that survived. Puerto Rico, Cuba. I know New Zealand, of course, hit. People don't even know New Zealand exists. They're like left off the map a lot of the time. So that's a technicality. But either way, the British last one, that was pretty cool to finally do something like this, and right before the new expansion. I was only able to do this because the game was able to run so well. It's so much faster now. At least it's consistently, it's not staggering as much, so that helped out a ton. I wouldn't have been able to do it otherwise. Anyways, thanks for watching. See you next time. Thank you to the February patrons: Bob, Riley Adams, Mayonnaise Incorporated, Seth A, Tyler Beach, Vinny Chang, Pilovsky, Ballin' Like Stalin, Birthday Daddy, Militime, Sleeper 56, Alfonso M6, Pizza, Maxi G, Swiss Argo, Elijah Senpai, and Elfie C.